Honorable members, I'm presenting this loan on the back of your rejection of a framework agreement between the People's Republic of China and the Gambia on this loan agreement. I'm not so that members understand the consequences of this or what the loan implies for the Gambia. Let me come up with the motion for this broadband agreement network.
Implications here. Can we just have a short break? Because the two are sort of interrelated.
You've voted for your own reasons, which maybe I'm not privy to. But this broadband network is a loan that this government had entered into to uplift the IT sector in this country. All this fiber optic cable around the whole country to bring the speed from the currently low levels of networks and IT connectivity to high speed from the poor services that we are getting to transform this sector. The government, the cabinet approved, and we went into this negotiation. And during our trip, we signed this loan agreement. This is what will move the sector. Currently, we are trying to implement the liberalization of the gateway network. This has revenue implications. And a lot of this also revenues are put in your budget. This will allow e-data, electronic data for the country. It will allow electronic processing of your ports, for some which some of you are complaining. It will allow e-tax administration. You don't have to fill the forms to go to income tax. You can sit and do your tax. And this is the way that all developing countries, all developed countries have gone through. Is the next step. Our sister countries, Cape Verde has gone. The hotels are all linked to their database. You book in, you pay. The tax is immediately registered to the database. You buy something, the VAT is immediately registered. And what this has done is, it seals the leakages in the government's revenue mobilization to the extent that all these countries who have gone through this have increased their revenue by almost twofold. I'm surprised. I don't know your reasons, but you don't want to move Gambia's telecommunication sector forward. For what reasons? You don't know. But this has implications for generations to come. This is not just a loan on its own. No, we fought for this law with conditions from IMF and World Bank that the country cannot go, but say no, this is a project that is cross-cutting, that has value for yourselves as mobile. It can bring in cable TV, ADSL. So What you are doing is to throw away that development in the telecommunications industry. And you will answer to your own consequences.
Honorable Speaker.
Yes.
We all know that
can we allow
we all know that there should be decorum. About decorum. I said the issue is about decorum in this National Assembly. We have not even voted for this yet. He is trying to convince us to support the loan. I don't think anybody has said they will not endorse the loan that is that he is proposing. But it seems that the minister is alleging that we have thrown something out and is really making accusation. I don't think that is proper, Honorable Speaker.
I'm not aware of any accusation, but
Speaker, she is directly doing that. We are respectful of you.
You are talking about decorum.
That's exactly.
Exactly. You are not.
Then behave that way.
You are not behaving.
You are not behaving yourself.
You are not, can you please order him out of this assembly?
Can you do
please?
That? You can you do that? Are you getting mad? What?
Please,
you cannot do that here.
Point of order.
Point of order.
You better behave. We are respecting you. So respect yourself.
Please, can you?
Can I answer that point for him?
Honorable please.
Because
signing at arms, point, please,
point of
can you get what? Him out of the assembly?
Point of observation.
Please.
Can I put them?
Signing at arms for the third time. Can you please take the honorable member of the assembly out of the assembly?
For what reason, order. Madam? You want
motion,
to know the
reason? I have a motion. Motion, Honorable Speaker.
Yes.
I want to move a motion.
You are at liberty. Go ahead, minority leader, with your motion.
That's it.
Speaker, I move a motion for the House to be suspended for the meantime.
Pardon?
I move a motion for you to suspend the House for the meantime.
Before we suspend the House, can I have my order respected, please?
Yes, I think... Minority, that's what you should do for us. Let's start to put the House in order and then we suspend it. But just like this, let's talk.
What I'm saying, I move a motion that we suspend the House till we put ourselves in order.
No, let the order be carried out first before we suspend the sessions. Simple.
Sergeant at Arms, please, can you order the honourable the honourable member for Serekunda out of this National Assembly for this sitting, please. Yes.
Honorable Speaker, I think as a woman we have given, I have given you tremendous respect. You must bear that in mind. It is not in my character to demean, especially a woman. Okay, just. Are you listening to me, or you are not willing to listen to what I have to say? Are you listening to me? I am saying that we wish to give you the respect that is due, and consequently, we want this house to move. We want to do our job. I spoke about decorum. You said I have not shown it. Yes, then I have withdrawn my own statements and expressed my own apology. Could we now proceed?
Thank you, ma'am. I move a motion for the House to be suspended till we let Rama regularize the issues happening in the House.
Any seconder? Honorable Busumbana.
Ma, I second the motion for the sitting to be suspended.
It has been moved and seconded that we suspend the sitting till we come back at 3 o'clock so the House stands suspended. Thank you.
Why not?